For the meringue, we will need 5 egg whites. Make sure you don't get any yolks in there, not even a drop, because one drop of yolk will prevent your egg whites from rising. And then you will need 1/4 teaspoon of cream of tartar, 3/4 cup of sugar, 1/2 teaspoon of vanilla, and 1/2 cup of cashew. So first we will start with, this is roasted cashew, which I just popped into the oven and baked for a few minutes until it turns into a nice brown color. So first you'd like to grind your cashew. You don't want to make powder out of it. You want to leave a little, some big bits that you want to bite into it when you bite into the meringue. Into the bowl. There. Next, you want to whip your egg whites until it is nice and frothy, but not yet forming stiff picks. So just medium speed until you get a nice white and frothy egg white mixture. Then you want to add your cream of tartar. You want to slowly add your sugar. Now all the sugar's in there, you know, all you need to do is wait until you get stiff peaks. going to check if we already have steep peaks. Not yet. It's still medium. There, see? That is stiff. There. Now you don't want to overmix your meringue once it achieves the stiff peaks which you're looking for. So in the next part you only want to fold. So you add in your vanilla and about a third of your cashew and fold. There. Fold. Another third. Make sure you reach the bottom and last one. Now if you notice, a meringue doesn't have any leavening ingredient, no baking soda or baking powder. The only thing that makes this rise is the air that you put into it. So if you deflate it, then you deflate the meringue and you're going to have a flat sheet of wafer instead of a meringue cake. And this is the same thing that you use for pavlova, except you don't need fruits for the SANS rebound. So there, I'm just using a regular disposable piping bag. So now I have here a square pan and a square sheet of parchment paper, which I have marked with edible marker. You want to start preheating your oven to 325 Fahrenheit, and you're going to bake this for about 25 to 30 minutes until it turns brown. So you have to watch it because not all oven heats the same. So I'm going to just a little bit on the corners. Tiny dots to hold down the sheet of parchment. Start from the middle. There. That's it. Now, right after you pipe this, you want to immediately bake it. Because if you keep it on the table for a long time, it will deflate. The purpose of the cream of tartar is to keep it from deflating too quickly. I need space there. You just want to flatten it because you're going to stack this, so you want to make sure that the tops are flat so they will stack nicely. I marked it so that I'm sure that I make perfect circles, and I make circles of the same size so that when I stack them, they're going to look nice and even. So if you get out of the circle, you just put that back in. If you don't have cream of tartar, you can replace it with vinegar or lemon juice of the same amount. So we are going to bake this at 325, again for 15 to 30 minutes, or until it turns a nice golden brown. Make sure you watch it. You don't want to burn your meringue. There we go. Right now, this is our baked meringue after we baked it for 20 minutes. You want to make sure it's cooled down before you try to remove it from the baking paper. There. And just put it in. Alright, we now have a steaming pot of water. And we're going to mix our egg whites. And sugar. And put it on top of our cup. Now you need to immediately whisk it or your eggs will get cooked. You want to turn down the heat to a simmer, like low medium, so that you don't immediately cook your egg yolks. You can do the same process using a sugar syrup process, but I'm not really a fan of sugar syrups. They kind of burn really bad. So I stick to double boilers even when I'm doing other kinds of buttercream. So you do this until all of the sugar has dissolved. Maybe around 5 to 7 minutes. Now I'm going to take a spatula and scrape off the sides. There is still some sugar and yolk sticking there. Don't want super high heat in the rolling boil because that will cook your egg yolks. So you just want a simmer so it just warms up your mixture and melts the sugar. It's almost there. You can actually see the granules, so you know if it's all gone. I still see some. I'm going to switch to a silicone spatula so that I can scrape off the very bottom. Just make sure you really mix it and don't stop because that will cook your egg yolks. Okay, I see that there's only very little granules, sugar granules left. So I'm going to take this off the heat. I'm going to turn off the heat and just let this, let the simmer do the rest. This off the pot. Switch on to a hand mixer. Now we are going to switch on over to thank you. nice and light, but it's still not yet fluffy. So you want to let it cool down a little before you start mixing it. You start off at low speed, just to cool down the mixture. Medium speed and whisk this until it's nice and light and fluffy. Now looks nice and light and fluffy. We are going to add our butter, which is slightly cold but not hard. Quite nicely. We just want to scrape off the sides of the bowl. Make sure everything is incorporated. Thank you, Nella Mac, for my Betty Crocker spatula. About 5 minutes of whisking is enough to get this all together. Thank you. nice and fluffy. See? Now we're going to assemble our SANS rebal cake. Right now we will start assembling our SANS rebal. Now if you want to add flavor to your SANS rebal, this is the perfect time. You can add, if you want cake-flavored SANS rebal, you just crumble your cake and then spread it on here before you put your meringue. Also, in between and on top. Like maybe you want red velvet, then you can go ahead and first spread your buttercream. It's nice and silky, right? Like that. And then you crumble, let's say, red velvet up on top. Me, I just want walnut. So I'm going to use my my food processor, my bullet food processor, and I am going to grind some nuts. Right now. So what I do with my nuts, I roast them or I bake them and then I freeze them so they don't go rancid. So there, I'm going to just spread it on top. I like a lot of nuts in my food. And for the middle part, I'm just going to add another layer of buttercream. This is French buttercream and it's really very good. It's not too sweet. Of course, you can adjust the sweetness according to your taste. It's nice if you have layers of the same size. SANS rebal really has a lot of buttercream, so generous portions is okay. then you want to cover the sides. You don't want the meringue to show, so you cover it all up. So it's like a surprise when you slice it. Of course, that's still going to be covered with nuts. Clean up the edges of your thank you brittle. Wait, that's way too much for me to wipe off.